What's this?
Hello, welcome to the Freak Show. Pompey McSquiggums here. I want to thank you all for joining me as I start up my coverage of March of the Living. It is by Machine 22 and Creaky Corpse. It released today, April 20th, 2016, and it's at 10% off until the 27th of April. So if you guys want it at a discount, you better act fast. What is March of the Living? Well, it's a very hard game to describe. Think of like a zombie apocalypse that's got tactical pause. You have an entire group of up to six people, and it's kind of FTL-esque, so faster than light-esque. It's really hard to describe 100%, but it's a lot of fun, and I'm really, really, really excited to show it to you guys right here, right now. I played around with it a little bit earlier today, as I saw it released today, and as you guys know, I've been scrambling to catch up from being sick. So, yeah, first hands-on experience earlier today, and this is not going to be a first look, but we're going to try to get a full run in. So, let us begin. Unfortunately, I haven't unlocked any individual characters beyond the initial Greg. Greg, if that is your real name. But there's also Anna, Derek, and Blake. But, again, we're starting with Greg here. He's our starting character. He's got an old revolver, a hammer, and a flashlight. And he's also a pistol expert, so he's really, really, really ridiculously good with pistols. He's meh with shotguns and meh with rifles. He's steadfast and decisive. Greg might not be the luckiest man alive, but when his mind is made up, there's no dissuading him from his course. He'll stop at nothing when it comes to finding his ex-wife and child. Let's begin, shall we? Alright, and we're loading, and we're done loading. For the past couple of weeks, you've been barricaded up in your home, trying to get a hold of your ex-wife Chloe over the phone. No one on the other end has ever picked up, though, and this made you worried for both her and your son, Tom, over whom she has custody. Even though you and Chloe may not have parted on the best terms 2 years ago, you still care about them and want to be sure that they're both safe in this post-apocalyptic nightmare. Storing as many supplies as you can realistically carry in your old car, you drive over the state borders, or border, toward their home. Soon enough, your vehicle runs out of fuel and grinds to a halt. Just before you ditch it, though, you hear an interesting broadcast over the radio. Survivors in the secured city of Wellston, far to the east, claim to have a ship which they plan to use to find sanctuary offshore. If you can find Chloe and Tom, maybe you can take them there. It's time to start our journey on foot. Alright, folks, and here we are. This is pretty much how the game plays out. We're going to be on something along these lines right here. So essentially, you can move around anywhere on the little map or within the road. At times, there will be zombies coming from the left and or the right. You have a map, which will allow you to go from place to place, very, very much like FTL. And then you have your 3 meters that you have to be aware of, your health, your fatigue, and your hunger. As you travel or fight or do whatever, fatigue's going to go down. So is hunger. If you get hit by anything, you're going to get injured and your health will go down. If you lose all your health, you obviously die. I mean, it's all very simple. You have 6 slots for characters. I've never actually found another survivor that joined my group, so I will be very surprised when that actually happens. We have an old revolver right now, we have 20 pistol bullets, and we have 5 food rations. So, let's get to stepping, shall we? Alright, we start off way over here, and we have to traverse all this crazy chaotic mess to get to Chloe's apartment there, and then eventually, all the way down over here to get to whatever's next. And then we get to go further and further. So this could actually take us like 400 episodes to get that far. I don't think it'd be that long, guys and gals. But who can say? I'm trying to plot my course here. I think I'm going to go here to here to here to here. Or maybe to, from here to here to here to there. Yeah, I think that's going to be the play. All right, so to this spot and beyond. So here we are, we're walking, and stuff randomly happens. You'll see up here how far you have to walk, the growls will be getting louder, occasionally there'll be monsters that eat you, zombies, that come up to fight you or whatever, and usually when you get to the end of something, something happens. You're plodding along on your own path, minding your own business, but you can't help but feel a general sense of unease. You're well aware that there don't seem to be any rotters around, and since there's open terrain for miles, you'd spot any other human beings before they came within a distance to harm you. And yet, you can't quite put your finger on why things feel off, like there's someone Or something spying on you. Well, it's probably nothing, you say aloud. Tempting fate, perhaps. But nothing appears in front of you, so I feel like you're, well, probably safe. Okay, apparently we didn't die a horrible, awful death. Yay for success in small things. Alright, on to the next spot. Uneventful things are not necessarily bad things, folks. Just so you know. The growls are still pretty minuscule. We're almost to our destination, and what's going to happen here? You are instantly alerted by a large volume of gunfire up ahead on the road. As you unholster your weapon, a small group of survivors runs past, shooting at the large horde bearing down on them. Some of the rotters spot you and start charging at you. Time to fight. Round one, fight. Alright, so we have two different types of a shooty pew pew action that we have. We have aim at the body, small chance to instantly kill the target and immobilize the target for a few seconds, does 8 damage, has got a 20% chance to hit the head, and a 30% chance to break grapple. You fire quite a bit, so like you'll charge for a couple seconds and then you'll just be like, bap, 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 and just unload on them. However, you can aim at the upper body and have a much higher chance to hit the head, 85%, which will give you an instant kill. But it takes you 2.8 seconds to charge, and you only fire once before you have to charge again. So there's some bad stuff. If you take a look down here, you'll see that you have a 90% chance to hit right there, 90 out to here, then it's 80 and 80. So these guys are all within the 80 chance to hit. We're going to go with the shoot the head thing, and we're going to start unloading on this guy right here. And bam. Well, we hit him, but we didn't hit him in the head, and then we missed. Well, this is a bad start to our action here, so we click to run away. We are faster than the zombies, so that is a good sign. And they don't immediately hit you. They have to actually, like, swing at you. There's a few seconds here. So you can pretty easily juke around, but bullets are not permanent or unlimited, so... yeah, things can get a little bit dicey from time to time. Alright, we're gonna take another shot here. And unfortunately, that missed as well. We are getting pretty unlucky right now, I gotta say. Alright, we're out of bullets. We have to reload. I'm gonna reload, but I'm gonna switch to my hammer and show you how the melee combat works. Alright, the reloading's done. We go up to manage group. I should have probably paused the game with spacebar. You can pause at any point, guys. Pause it with spacebar to change your group and change where you're going. So when you have six people, you're gonna obviously need to do multiple things. Alright, so we're gonna come over here and I'm gonna select good old Greg here. We're gonna go over here and we're gonna smack this guy in the face. Hammer to the head, rest in peace, victoriousness is ours. After you dispatch the last of your foes, you turn around to see if you can find the a-holes who dump their problems on you. But by now, though, they've moved far beyond your reach. If you ever see them again, you're going to tear them a new one. Alright, well, we managed to get a toy hand grenade. Looks quite real, but the boom is not included. Well, that's unfortunate. You will find random merchants and traders along the way as well. So there are times where you can actually sell some cool stuff. Alright, well, we're pretty hungry and we're relatively tired. I'm gonna eat right now. We're not gonna... I'm not gonna eat right now. We're gonna check out the map. We're here. We want to get all the way to there. Well, I suppose we can go there as well. They're both pretty far away. How about I head here and then I go down there? I think that's gonna be the play. This is a little bit shorter and it might give us a little bit of time to do what we gots to do. Alright, you're walking along a highway, and there are a number of seemingly abandoned vehicles stretched out in a line. Looks like they were traveling in a convoy and were stopped for whatever reason. There is a small presence of rotters here who currently aren't paying you too much attention. Well, we're going to check the vehicles. You rifle through the entire convoy quickly and efficiently. You quickly store away all your findings to leave before you attract further attention. Cool. You got a food ration and some shotgun shells. Okay. Well, unfortunately, we are going to have to rest. So, before we rest, it's always a good idea. Select your guy. You can do it with the number keys or clicking on them. Get toward the middle of the road and then rest, because if you have to wake up, you're going to need time to actually do this. Oh, that's right. You sleep over at the side. I totally forgot. I forgot they put you all the way over to the edge. Well, we're going to sleep. Now, what happens when we go hungry is we get a permanent health decretion, or our health goes down. Temporary. It temporarily goes down, so what we have to do to get it back is just simply eat. We have six rations right here, and we're gonna gobble up one of them, and we're back to full health, full fatigue, and full hunger. We haven't been hit yet, so that's why we're at full health. No, I don't want to rest. I want to map. Alright, so we're gonna map. Then we're gonna head here. It's 20 kilometers away. We should be fine, though. Alright, well, we're just gonna continue on. The growls mean that we're getting closer to nasty things. If they get to a certain point, zombies will pop up and try to eat us. Ear-piercing beeps can be heard going off within a few seconds of each other. A car alarm is going off not too far from here. A figure can be seen inside, with several infected beating and pounding on the vehicle. I'm going to investigate the situation. You get closer to the vehicle, but still cannot make out if the figure is an infected or a survivor. The alarm has covered up the sounds of your footsteps, and rotters have not noticed your presence. Move to get a better view. You're just a few meters away from the vehicle now and see a biter struggling in the driver's seat. The seatbelt has begun to dig into its chest, so it must have been there for a while. None of the infected have noticed you, making it easy to pass through. Well, at least we got lucky with that one, right? Alright, well, we're going to go here. These things are actual cities. You'll be able to scavenge at the cities to get more resources, whether it be health kits, ammunition, sometimes weapons, food. You name it, you can get a whole bunch of stuff in the city, so it's always a good idea to head to those places. Alright, so, let's see here. You arrive at Golden Meadow. Cities are a great place to find supplies. Also very dangerous. Alright, so, at this point, what do we want? Let's go to the grocery store. Alright, if you search for 20, 40, and 60 minutes, you have better chances of finding stuff or finding more things, but you also have a higher chance of encountering a nasty group of bad guys. We're going to go with the 20-minute one right now. 27% chance, and we got exceptionally unlucky, and unfortunately, fighting a group of these guys with just a hammer, probably not the play. So we're going to swap on over to our pistol. Going to select our guy here, and we are going to switch over to the headshot maneuver here. And apparently we have to reload because I removed my weapon from my inventory because I clicked the wrong button. And we're going to shoot the guy with the fedora or the French hat. I don't know what that is. There we go. Alright, let's continue on. Continue on, and the beret would be a French hat. It looks more like a fedora. Alright, we're just going to run right on past the little zombie shamblers as we do. And hopefully we've got enough oomph to take these guys out. 80%. Move here, take another shot. And the last one, I am not opposed to using the hammer. You don't instantly die when you start getting chewed on, by the way. So that is a good sign. And bam! Get wrecked. Alright, so rest in peace, Zambi. Rest in the peasted. Unfortunately, we didn't actually get anything at all. Usually you still get something when that happens. Alright, we're going to go for the 40 minutes at the drugstore. In hopes that we... Man, we are just severely unlucky. I'm not even sure I want to... I want to try fighting some of these guys with the hammer. Uh-oh, we've been grappled, huh? Well, the character is grappled, he can't move, and might be bitten by the infected. To break free, the melee pushback can be used to... Oh, cool. I have never been grappled before. We've been pushed free, but man, that was brutal. Alright, so we're not going to try that again. That was a bit rough. We will reload. We're going to try to shoot this guy in his face. And it, I don't know if we hit his face, but we shot him. He definitely got shot. Oh, we were using the wrong shooty thing. That's why. And kerblap. We get away. We could flee, but fleeing is actually a little risky, too. Because you kind of like zigzag back and forth until you go off the bottom of the screen. It's kind of... And you don't get anything for it. Sometimes still killing zombies, you get something for it. Alright, so we got that guy. As you see, things are not going super well, but they're not going too bad. We got chewed on once, but, you know, that's all fine and good. Nobody minds getting gnawed on by a zombie every now and then. They mind when they miss their shots. Alright, we're going to switch back over to our hammer really, really rapidly here. And we're going to hope that we can actually murder this guy with a hammer. Bam! Bam! Alright, so he's actually done. Well, we tried for the swing there. It totally didn't work. We're going to run right past these guys. We're going to continue. We're going to man up. We're going to go melee on these guys. We don't even care. It ain't no thing. There we go. We bapped somebody upside the noggin there. Rest in pieces, Zambi. Thankfully, we are slightly quicker than the Zambies when it comes to beating on them. So as you see, if we don't get grappled, we pretty much do a really, really good job of defeating them with hammers to their face and skulls. So there is that, and that's it. There we are. So I've learned that you need to kind of conserve some ammo. We're down to not that many left. We did get a bandage, and we did get some food rations, which are both good. We're going to use the bandage right away. We're back to full health. Now the fun part here is resting. So we're going to search for a safe place to rest. And sometimes you'll find it, sometimes you won't. This is one of those times where we won't. Now this is bad for many reasons. One of them is, well, we have less than ideal situations for combat right now. The fatigue, as you guys can see, I'm going to actually pause here. Fatigue, hit chance, penalty is -5, melee, damage penalty is -1, speed is -10, and break grapple penalty is -5%. So all of these are bad. Oh, we just got grappled. We need to push him back. There we go, grapple was broken. Oh my goodness, this is just not going well for us. Alright, well, we're back to doing some murder-death killing here, hopefully, theoretically, possibly. There we go. Just crack him upside the noggin. Crack him upside the skullin. Skullify him. Make his insides his outsides. Blunt force trauma, go! Man, fatigue is a real thing, and it is really not great. Also, if you move like I just did right before the last smackify upside the faceify, I think you cancel your attack. It doesn't actually hit. So you actually need to see the blood splattering all over the place for you to do this correctly. If you see miss come up, you can just immediately back away. Alright, and boom! And we should be able to handle this guy, if we don't miss. We will hit you with our billy club hammer of doom! And eventually, there it is. Ah, we got a wallet, sweet. If money is ever worth something again, someday it might become useful. Sweet, rifle bullets, a wedding ring, will you marry me, a diamond ring? None of these are super useful, honestly. I had a diamond ring, I'm like, oh! Sweet, we got a diamond ring, that's gonna be worth a ton, but it says it used to be worth a lot of money, but not anymore. Should have read that, but I didn't. So, there's that, I suppose. Well, we still need to rest, and a safe place to rest is better than no place. And it looks like we found a safe place, yay! Alright, so we shall sleep, and the rain is gonna actually make things a lot worse for us. And as you see, we are not gaining our fatigue back very quickly due to the rain. And it's taking its sweet time, but it's getting there. We're missing some health due to hunger, but that will come back. And we're still missing health because we got chewed on once. But so far, not too bad. Not too bad. Yeah, this was originally going to be a first look video, but this game's a lot of fun. And I really, 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 really want to play it more. I want to do a full run. Games like this that have you know, a very definite end that's not, well, I don't say it's not too far or too hard to get to, but it's not like 700 episodes or something that, you know, it's not going to be that long to get to. I definitely don't mind going and doing some stuff. Let's see if we can't get some more bullets and other such various things. And let's see if we can get lucky and not actually have a freaking engagement. Yay, we did it. All right, ooh, pistol bullets too. Perfect for us. All right, we're going to go scavenge the apartments. 30% chance for this. And survey says, another one where we sidewalk chalk. Alright, I think we're going to get rid of the toy hand grenade for some sidewalk chalk. That might be useful. Maybe it's not. I don't know. We're going to go to the hospital, see if we can't get ourselves some resources to heal up. But they can be very useful. Alright, sweet. We got through all of that. We're going to put the wallet down. We're going to actually use this right away. And we're going to pick the wallet back up. And we're going to head on to the apartment. To Chloe's apartment. We're going to hope for the best here. Oh, we're about to get murdered. You saw the noise level went up really, really crazy. Alright, we're only up against two rotters, so we should be able to walk on over and own him. A big smack upside his face. We're going to go again. Oh, we missed. Backing away. cracking away, and we should be able to end this guy somewhat simplistically. Oh, unless we miss. If we miss, it's not that simplistic. Alright, we're going to try to dismantle. Oh, he got a good hit on us. I figured we'd just keep hitting him over and over, and he wouldn't actually be able to do anything. Let's get rid of the wedding ring, get the fishing rod. I'm assuming, like, fishing might actually be a way of feeding yourselves in this post-apocalyptic world, so, yeah. We're going to travel the remaining little tiny bit of stuff that we have to. You arrive outside your ex's apartment, carefully entering the front lobby through the shattered glass front door. You keep an eye out for the infected as you make your way to the third floor. To your dismay, you find fresh blood sprayed across the walls in a macabre display. Matching the cordite smell and mix of human and rotter corpses throughout the building. This place must have fallen recently, making you fear the worst for your ex-wife and kid. You sneak over to the door of Chloe's apartment and listen carefully. You're alarmed to hear pottery smashing to the ground. Someone inside must be looting the place, or maybe it's some infected that got stuck inside. You're not sure, but it's cause for concern. You ready your weapons, just in case. Enter the apartment! As quietly as you possibly can, you slowly open the apartment door and creep inside. It's difficult to see, with the light seemingly shot out. Peeking around the corner into the large living room, you see a lone figure tearing the place apart, tossing aside piles of clothing and junk, trying to find something of value. This figure, a short, sniveling man, has a shotgun slung over his shoulder and seems incredibly agitated. You watch him for a moment and notice him shaking and making strange noises every time he lays a finger on something. We'll try the diplomatic approach. Alright, you call out to the man from across the room, maintaining a safe distance. The stranger whips around on the spot, pulling the shotgun off his shoulder and shakily aiming it at your stomach.
I was here first. Get out. This is my spot.
After that, the man starts shouting incoherently. This is looking sketchier by the moment. Flashlight. Offer him your flashlight if he promises to calm himself and lets you look for signs of your child.
You've got yourself a deal, the man says, taking your flashlight, but I'm keeping an eye on you. Don't try anything stupid.
You move past him and start searching for clues of the whereabouts of your son and ex-wife. Search the apartment. You search the bedroom and find a corpse laid out on your former bed, its face disfigured by, oh no. There's no mistaking that short dark blonde hair, those highlights, poor Chloe. You're going to find whoever murdered your ex-wife and completely destroy them. Enraged, you walk out of the room. There's no sign of Tom, but by searching the apartment further, you find a note scribbled on a torn shred of paper signed by Zach, your ex's bastage of a boyfriend. We'll read the note. Warren! As always, you're late. I'm taking off out of this crappy place and going to my cabin. You know the place. I'm stuck with this stupid kid right now, but I figure we'd use him to sneak into places and steal crap. If he dies, he dies. Anyway, don't waste time. You know where to find me. Zach. You have mixed feelings about the situation. While you're glad that Tom wasn't left to die here with his mother, it's clear that Zach doesn't care about him the way you do. You know all about the cabin Zach is talking about, considering it used to be yours before it was taken in the divorce. You remember Tom complaining about how dirty it was when he was taken there by his mother last summer. The fact that Zach isn't taking care of the place pisses you off.
Head to your old cabin.
Okay, so there we have it. We can actually rest here as well for free. It's a safe zone, so if you make it to this place, this is a free and safe place to rest. Which isn't necessarily bad. Unfortunately, the only way to restore health that I found is actual medical supplies. So, be aware of that. We're going to go to our map now, and we are going to go and try to head that way. And we're going to try to hit all the places to scavenge along the way. Hopefully, it will be good for us, but there's no guarantee. And we're about to get attacked once again. And it's a single rotter. It is in the rain. We should be fine, but yeah, you never know. You never know, he might be Bruce Zombie or something. I don't know. I don't know what to tell you guys. But we got beat down by the last Zambi that we tried to hammer in the face. It was hammer time, but not hammer time enough. Alright. And good day, sir. Rifle bullets, yay! Travel the remaining 3.3K. There is an overturned truck in the road, apparently used to transport exhibits to a wax museum. The contents have long since spilled out, and many have melted in the sun. It's a gruesome, albeit fake, sight. However, the wax figures apparently used real props, and it may be worth checking for a weapon.
Search the truck!
As you approach the truck, you trip over one of the wax dummies. A few seconds later, you realize that you aren't the only one getting up. Several of the deformed wax dummies are actually real infected or inflected. We're up against three. You know what? We'll stay with the melee. We can do the abusive melee beatdown thing that we've been doing. Oh, I turned away too quick. I got nervous. They growled at me. I get nervous when things growl at me. I'm like, oh no, it's gonna eat me. It's gonna eat my brain. There we go. We got a hit. Man, we're not getting headshots at all. We're just slowly, like, breaking limbs and shoulders and stuff. I mean, granted, it's painful, but probably less so to a zombie than, say, a real person. Alright, well, he should be dead no matter what. Now, let's see if we can't deal with this guy. Nope. Man, our melee skills are turtified. Turtifiable. Bam! Come on, land a headshot. There it is. There's the insta-give that we're looking for. Do it again. Like, when I was doing this my first time, when I was playing through it on my own, I was getting, like, headshots almost every time. I don't know if anybody even survived past the first one. Oh, gosh. He's doing a ninja kata there. You guys saw it. That was some karate. Boom.
Rest in peace.
You stumble away from the truck and leave any remaining infected to rot in the sun. A cheap weapon isn't worth the risk. Oh, it may have been worth the risk. I'm just saying. All right, well, let's map on through to the next place. We'll hopefully be able to find a place to rest there. Our fatigue is coming, but we're going to use some of our pistol ammo if we do run into any more growls, which it looks like we may. The growls are getting real. We're still 12K away. We're kind of outranging them a little bit, but not 100%. We made it, though. Alright, what we're going to do now is rest. We're going to look for a safe place to rest. Hopefully we find it. And we don't get eaten by nasty things. Yay! We are heroes, sort of. Alright, so after we're fully rested, we'll om-nom up on one of our food rations, and then we will go and do murder. Or hopefully find stuff and not have to do murder. Again, I'm looking forward to getting multiple people. I think that's going to be a lot of fun, but we'll see. We'll see. Chances are what I'll do is have one person with the gun, maybe, and then do, like, the melee dance with other people. I'll let the one with the gun just sit back and shoot over and over again. I think that's going to be a lot of fun. Oh, yeah, we got to eat first. I will confirm that you wish to be fed, and I have done so. Alright, so we're going to start off at the police station. 41% chance. Are we going to be lucky this time or not? Only time will tell. Ooh, we are lucky. Alright, we got pistols, we got shotguns. Alright, the hammer is 6 damage, the pipe is 8. Attack delay is plus 25%, and the fatigue is plus 4. Now, I don't know if it's worth the change. We're going to hold the pipe for now, but I don't know if I'm going to swap. Like, it seems like it's good, but we might not be fast enough to move before the zombies hit us. So I'm hesitant to actually commit to that fully. Alright, we're going to go to the hospital. 28% chance. Watch, this time we'll trigger the zone. Oh, no. Alright. But we didn't actually get anything either. That's kind of weak. To the drugstore. 40 minutes. 32% chance. We're playing with fire, folks. Well, we got food rations. I was kind of hoping for medical supplies. We'll continue to scavenge. We'll try to get through all of these. And then we'll probably break off the episode before we leave this place. Still, not too bad overall, I gotta say. Alright, ooh, a crowbar. Why would a crowbar be less good than a hammer? That seems very bizarre to me. I figure, like, a crowbar would definitely be better. I mean, you would get tired. Like, a pipe would be really good. How would you have more attack delay with a pipe than with a hammer? I don't know. And having that extra range from a pipe, you'd think that would just be amazing. But apparently, it's not that great. Alright, I'm going to swap the wallet for a pipe. And I think that's... We're just going to go with that. I don't know. Alright, one more scavenging, and then we're done. We're going to go for the 60-minute one. Maybe we get super lucky here. Maybe we get into a fight. I don't know. I'm hoping for the luck. If we are lucky, great. Nope, it's fight time. There are a lot of them. It is time for us to go revolver style. Alright, we're going to get a bit closer before we start unloadifying. We'll unloadify on this guy first. And we totally missed, and now we have to reload. Oh gosh, I have no idea why he just stopped there briefly. That was weird. Man, our guy is terrible. Has he gone blind in his old age or something? Did he get shot in the eye or something? Or scratched in the cornea? Oh, darkness chance, because we don't have a flashlight anymore. Ah, that explains why we're aiming so poorly. The flashlight actually removes your darkness penalty of being able to aim. Okay, rest is going to be hammer time. We're going to reload, and then we're going to go all hammer style on him. Pause? I almost didn't pause. Alright, we're going to try this. I forgot it unselects your character when you go through the pause menu, and occasionally you'll also see this happen. Where, like, hammer or pipe or whatever actually stays on the screen. Alright, we got a smack there. Another smack, alright. Third smack, and this might be enough to finish him. Not quite. This should end it. Oh, but we missed.
Grr! Hit him in the face!
Wow, this dude's super ridiculously tanky. Alright, victory is ours. Food rations for the win. We will take that, and we will enjoy it, and it will be glorious. Anyway, folks, I think that is going to do it for this particular episode. I hope you guys enjoyed. I will be back sometime by the end of the week with at least one more episode. Possibly two, maybe 40 more episodes. I don't know. It's a really fun game, guys. You should definitely check it out. If you want more information about the game, where to get the game, information on the developer will all be down below in the description of the video, like it always is. The game, once again, is called March of the Living. Just released today. Go check it out. It's awesome. Get it. Do it. Love it. Survive. I don't know. Anyway, guys, until the very next episode, my name is Bumpy McSquiggums. Thank you for stopping by the Freak Show, and I will see you later.